1850, Waxahachie became recognized as a town in North Texas. By May of 1885, Waxahachie added its first mayor, E.A. Dubose. During the time, a lot of changes were being made to the city. New buildings were being built, and cotton production was a growing business. Railroads were being added, along with the telephone service. But there was also a lot of fires, which burned many buildings. It wasn't until 1883 when a fire department was finally added. And it wasn't until 1895 when the construction of Waxahachie's current courthouse was completed. But along with the building came a legend that is still around today, the legend of the Ellis County Courthouse. The nine-story building is known as a Richardsonian Romance courthouse, which has design roots that link to French, Spanish, and Italian architecture from the 11th and 12th century. The architect, Harry Hurley, was known for building many courthouses and churches across the country. Legend has it that he moved to Texas to work on Waxahachie's new courthouse. During his stay at a boarding house in Texas, he fell in love with the owner's granddaughter, whose name was Mabel Frame. In his works, he decided to carve her face on the columns of the courthouse, but she did not love him in return. Because of this, as he continued to work tirelessly into the early hours of morning on the carving, the rejection he received slowly turned to anger, and so he started to make the carvings uglier and uglier as time passed by, to the point where her face no longer looked human, but more like a demon, which many suggest is actually a monster known as the Green Man. Green Man was a traditional European figure at the time, and since Hurley was trained as a European architect, it would make sense that the carvings are not of Mabel, but instead of Green Man. But no one knows for certain what his intentions were, and no one knows for certain what became of Hurley, but records suggest he married another woman and moved to Dallas. For now, the legend of Ellis County Courthouse will remain as a mystery, but it will also remain as an example of how corrupted thoughts can cause corrupted actions.